few weeks ago, a number of American public officials signed an open letter to the president that was published in the Washington Post and in the New York Times. There were 12 of us. There were 3 governors. There were 2 ambassadors. There was 1 mayor of New York City, the largest city in the country. There were 2 congressmen. There were 1 head of the FBI and 1 attorney general. And of the 12 of us, we were Democrats, we were Republicans. We worked for President Bush, we worked for President Clinton. It didn't matter. Congress has signed, many members of Congress have signed a resolution asking the President and the State Department to do the list. They were Republicans and Democrats. Gosh, in this town, you can't get Republicans and Democrats to agree that today is Saturday. Now, the President, again, he's a great lawyer. And Mr. President, you've had expert opinions from all of us. 2 generals, by the way, signed it. Both of whom served in Iraq. You're going to hear from Colonel Martin. And all of them said that in their expert opinion, the MEK was not a terrorist organization. So that's expert opinion, Mr. President, but we have a better piece of evidence. It's called circumstantial evidence. And circumstantial evidence means it's not direct evidence, it's not an eyewitness, but when you hear it, you understand that that means that the case is proved one way or the other. Since the MEK was delisted, not one open source terrorism database, and there are tens and tens of open source terrorism databases that keep track of terrorist incidents all over the world, not one of them has found one incident by the MEK of terrorism. Not one incident of MEK terrorism anywhere in the world against anybody or any country. So if for over a decade there hasn't been any evidence, not one incident of terrorism, what does that mean? It means that the MEK is not a terrorist organization. And as Tom Ridge said, loud and clear, as Tom Ridge said, many Americans were shocked when they learned about the fact that the Iranian government at very high levels was engaged in a plot to kill the Saudi ambassador here in Washington and kill U.S. citizens as well. Were any of you surprised? Of course not, because you know, and now everybody knows, that there is only one terrorist organization in this play, and that is the government of Tehran. Another reason that I supported President Obama so vigorously, and so did so many Americans, is because he promised that we were going to change the way things are done in Washington. He promised that we were going to have a government, the United States government, that stood for the highest of moral values, that made decisions not on what's politically expedient, but on what is right, on the things that go to the core of the American democracy, of the justice and fairness we believe we have in this country, right? And I think, by and large, the president has done that in many, many places. And he has used American power to protect people. When the president said we were going to go into Libya, an airstrike in Libya, the United States, the French, the British, NATO, he was criticized by a lot of his political rivals.